going to demonstrate laboratory 6, where I'll be purifying the red fluorescent protein from a culture that's expressing the RFP. I grew this culture from a pink colony that was made in the transformation lab. I'm going to go through a two-part process. In part A, I will separate out the cells and break them apart. In part B, I'll use column chromatography to filter out the cell parts and other waste so that all I'm left with is the red fluorescent protein. Here are the reagents and equipment that I'll be using in part A of lab 6. I have some equipment that looks familiar. I have my E.coli culture in the small tube. I have two buffers, lysis buffer and elution buffer. And then I also have a centrifuge, but it's more powerful than the centrifuge we've used in previous labs. And for the first time, I'll be using a P1000 pipette, which you'll notice is larger, has different numerical volumes, and has bigger tips. To collect the cells from our tube of E. coli culture, I need to spin this down in a centrifuge so that the cells move to the bottom. When I'm using this centrifuge, I need to be sure that I balance it just like the other centrifuges that I've used. So I have another tube here, and I'll place them directly across from each other. Now I'll spin the tubes for 5 minutes. You can see a pellet of pink cells has formed at the bottom of the tube. Now I'm going to remove the liquid waste from this tube, and I'm going to add another mil of E. coli culture from another tube so that we can double the size of our pellet. Now I'll repeat the process with the centrifuge and spin for another 5 minutes. Now I want to add 150 mils of elution buffer to the E. coli pellet, and then I'm going to rack it. I'm going to drag it across my tube rack to break up that pellet of cells and make sure I don't have any clumps left in the bottom. I want to be sure I don't have any clumps. Next, I'll add 150 microliters of lysis buffer to the E. coli tube, and then I'll drag it across the rack to mix it into solution. The lysis buffer will help to break open the cells so that we can separate the cell parts and other waste from our RFP. This process takes overnight at room temperature, so I'm just going to let it sit. This is the equipment and reagents that I'll be using for part B of lab 6. I have a column with resin beads in it that will help me to separate out the protein from my lysed cells. Here are my lysed cells, and then I'll be using a series of buffers: binding buffer, wash buffer, and elution buffer. I'll add the lyse cells to my column and then the buffers one at a time. The buffers are different salt concentrations, which will help the protein to either hold onto the resin beads or to let go and wash through with the solution. First, I need to label my tubes. Super is the tube where I will be adding the supernatant from the lysed cells. This is what I will pass through the column with the different buffers. The RFP tube is where I will collect the red fluorescent protein at the end. Next, I'm going to separate the cell waste by centrifuging the lyse cells for 5 minutes. The solution at the top, or the supernatant, contains my RFP and some other proteins. The pellet at the bottom contains the cell waste and debris. I can tell this because my supernatant is pink, but my cell pellet is white. Now, I'm going to take 200 microliters of the supernatant from my tube and add it over to my super tube. Each step of the column chromatography process will do different things to the cell materials in the solution. First, I'm going to drain off the excess column buffer that's in there from storage to just above the bed of resin. It's important not to let the resin come in contact with the air because the air will degrade the beads. Next, I'm going to add 200 microliters of the binding buffer to the supernatant. Mix it and add it to the column. The binding buffer will help some proteins, including the RFP, to bind to the resin while the cellular waste and other debris gets washed through. Next, I'll add 1 mL of wash buffer to the column and allow that to wash out any other proteins. Notice how the RFP stays bound to the resin at the top of the column. Now I'll add 2 mL of the elution buffer to the column, 1 mL at a time. The elution buffer causes the RFP to let go of the resin and move through the column. When I can see the pink solution coming at the bottom of the column, it's time to collect my RFP protein. After collecting all of the RFP, I will let the remaining solution drain out of the column, leaving just enough to protect the top of the resin bed and not expose any of it to air. Finally, I'll add 1 mL of column equilibration buffer to the column for storage. Now I can compare my original culture to my purified protein. I can also use a blue light to see how much it fluoresces, which is a general indication of how pure the protein is.